North Korea blasts rabid dog Trump for amassing war hardware beyond the danger line. North Korea have called Donald Trump a rabid dog and the country have sentenced the U.S. president to death, KCNA reported. The state-controlled media outlet made threats of its own as well as citing from the Rodong Sinmun, a puppet newspaper in the state. The report said, the U.S. is amassing war hardware in the waters off the Korean Peninsula and hurling its vassal forces including South Korea into the largest ever joint naval exercises proves that the U.S. bellicose attempt to bring down a DPRK by force has gone beyond the danger line. A commentary from the Rodong Sinmun on Monday says an insult to the dignity of the supreme leadership of the DPRK is the biggest insult to its army and people and an intolerable challenge to human mentality and conscience. Trump must clearly understand that his rubbish is leading the U.S., to say nothing of himself, on the irretrievable road to hell, the commentary says, and goes on. It is a stark reality that the old and ailing U.S. is heading towards hell. The mentally deranged money grabber dared point his finger at the sun. This has made him the criminal who is sentenced to death by the army and people of the DPRK. Those who challenge the dignity of the supreme leadership of the DPRK and its social system can never find their place to live under this sky. Rabid dog Trump will certainly be made to pay dearly for his hideous crime. The propaganda churned out by the state-controlled outlets will make its way across North Korea as its people as other forms of media are restricted. The increasingly aggressive rhetoric comes as rumors swirl surrounding a new military test from the Hermit Kingdom. It has been over 2 months since North Korea's last ballistic missile test. Sentencing Donald Trump to death will surely enrage the Republican firebrand as the war of words between the U.S. and North Korea is upped another gear. The slew of threats and insults from the rogue nation come as the country is left in fits of rage as the U.S. and South Korea conduct joint military drills near the peninsula of the region. South Korea's peace and security envoy Lee Doo-hoon has met with his U.S. counterpart Joseph Yun with increasing regularly as the superpower seeks a solution to Kim Jong-un's threatening regime. Donald Trump was recently asked to cease military drills around the peninsula or face a nuclear deterrent by the rogue nation, displaying the fury in Pyongyang over the exercises. Han Tae-song, the Hermit Kingdom's ambassador to the United Nations in Geneva, issued the stark warning to the U.S. president. He stated, "As long as there is continuous hostile policy against my country by the U.S. and as long as there are continued war games at our doorstep, then there will not be negotiations. There are continued military exercises using nuclear assets as well as aircraft carriers, and strategic bombers and then raising such kinds of military exercises against my country." The Hermit official stated that North Korea could consider abandoning its nuclear program, but that threats from America prevent considerations from taking place. He claimed, "This is the deterrent. The nuclear deterrent to cope with the nuclear threat from America." The ambassador kept the rogue nation's cards close to its chest after failing to clarify if the country is planning another ballistic missile test. He stated, "The DPRK, my country, will continue to build up its self-defense capability, the pivot of which is nuclear forces and capability for a triumphant strike as long as U.S. and hostile forces keep up nuclear threat and blackmail. Our country plans ultimate completion of the nuclear force." The North Korean added that the U.S. never accepted calling off their joint military exercises near the peninsula. He declared, "So if they accept such things, then we will think what we do in the future." The official disclosed the effects of the economic and military squeeze being put on Kim Jong-un's despot state constitute large-scale human rights violations and cited the delayed delivery of aid and consumer goods. He went on, "It is obvious that the aim of the sanctions is to overthrow the system of my country by isolating and stifling it and to intentionally bring about humanitarian disaster instead of preventing weapons development as claimed by the U.S. and its followers." Han Tae-song also affirmed that the rogue nation is preparing for further sanctions to be imposed. He said, The media is saying the Americans and Trump are considering such things. But that is their business, and then we don't mind what they want to do against my country, since the aim is quite clear. So we are ready for such kinds of measures taken by America against my country.